This is the Natural History Museum. I got here at 4 o'clock yesterday and they just were closing up. They're open till 5, but you gotta get in before 4. I walked over today. Actually, I wasn't here yesterday. I was here 2 days ago, because yesterday I went to the Great Wall because it was such a nice day out. I walked over from the Ancient Architecture Museum, which is worth a stop. To get down here from Tiananmen Square, bus 2 runs you down. It's convenient. Yes, entrance. I want to go this way. They have an audio guide I could do, or I could kind of wander around on my own, maybe. Forty Theater and Discovery World is upstairs. Second floor, Mystery of Animals in the Plant Kingdom. Beauty of Animals. Down here, let's see. Invertebrates, Origin of Life, Ancient Mammals, Ancient Reptiles, Temporary Exhibit, Friends of Humankind. And the basement's got the dinosaurs, human body, snack, play area, and aquarium. Let's see. I've got 2 hours, so it's just 3 o'clock now. So, mammals, good, there's no English. So I don't have to worry about being overwhelmed, huh? They're showing the line of elephants here. African, Asian elephant. The mammoth split off from the Asian elephants, huh? Primitive proboscidian, sea cow, hyrax, is that? Deinotheriums, hyrathosaurian, and Deinotherium. Woolly mammoth, Colombian mammoth. Sometimes if they have the Latin, it helps. Mammoth primigenius, so this is a Colombian mammoth. Mastodon. Platybelodon. Stegodon. Modern elephant. Platybelodon. Danovi Chennai. I was out in the Panhandle in Nebraska and they had an interesting national park site that had to do with primitive proboscidian find. This one looks like a giant warthog. Cuba, Cubano Carus Gigas Lee. Let's see. Evolution of Peri. So dactyls, they're walking on their toes. Evolution of horses, evolved in North America and then migrated to Asia. Went extinct in the Americas before they were brought back by explorers. Evolution of rhinoceros, brontotheres, evolution of pig. Arteriodactyls. Evolution of deer. Evolution of giraffe. Oh, copy, huh? They got down there. carnivores. This looks like one of the extinct wolves from the South Sea. Tasmanian wolf or something. Mammals, the teeth of mammals. You can tell what people are eating by their teeth, meaning animals, what they're eating by their teeth, primates. We got a jump start after 65 million years ago when the dinosaurs vacated. Little shrew-like creatures. Embolotherium andrewi. Hipparion. This is the hoof of a Hipparion. Cervus cocobuni. From Japan, probably, huh? Primitive deer. Pleistocene deer. Moratherium species. Dino. Crocata gigantes. Tragocerus gregarius. This is a Paraceratherium tianchinensis. Platybelodon. Paraceratherium tianchinensis. Plant eaters. Looks like a giraffe, but it's got four horns. Shanotherium tetelli. This big one back here is a stegodon. Zidansky, I told you to get back in your seat. Huge old horns, massive, look at that. What's this big guy? Look at those big old buck tooth, they look like they've been sawed off. That's where the bulldozer hit it. Maybe. Your clothes maybe, Beau Brummely, may stand out a mile, but baby, you're never fully dressed. Angiosperms are flowering plants. All the stuff that turned in from cycads to cones. Ginkgo, primitive trees, cordates, coniferax, angiosperms. Up here, flowering plants, yeah. Cycads are an offshoot here, huh? We still have a few cycads hanging out. When I was at the Dublin Botanical Gardens, I had discovered a new one from Australia. They had a sample growing there. Of one that was discovered. They thought it was lost forever. Cenozoic, Angiosperma era. Prosperous, Shanwang biota. There's a Shangri-La in Yunnan province that was discovered in the late 19th century. All this tropical stuff that shouldn't be growing that far north. In China. Origins of life on Earth a billion years ago. Let's see. Earth forms 4.6. Life appears a billion. 3 billion years, all life forms so tiny they can only be seen under the microscope. So 3.5 billion years ago, life forms, and then for the next 3 billion years, it's tiny, tiny. Then 530 million years ago, Cambrian explosion. Many of the Changjiang fauna fossils are evidence of this explosion. Solar system, Big Bang, solar system forms, origins of life on Earth, DNA. Here's a sculpture, all the primitive life forms, life of black smokers, life in the laboratory, life made in the laboratory? Ish, don't think so. Early life, prokaryota, stromatolites. Speaking of Australia. Is this shell plant evolving? Inner workings of a cell. We've got different fossils there. Better view. Fossil records. Unanocephalus unanensis. Do 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 do. Bo bromelain. Evolution of metazoa. Cambrian explosion. Explosions. Changjiang fauna. So it looks like they've got all the good tube worms and all that nasty stuff evolving in the ocean, duking it out to be the first complex life form. Chiali fauna. Darwin's theory a challenge. The beagle. Tree of life. Extinction events. So you have the Cambrian explosion and then the, what's the first die-off where like 95% of everything goes away. Dramatic climate change or catastrophic events or both. Everything dies off. Do do do. What do we got? Stromatolites. What are we looking at? Oh, bivalves. Bivalve animals? What is this? Oh, I'm not sure if they're showing clammy type animals. Cambrian explosion. Life of invertebrates evolved rapidly. During geological history, they experienced several extinction events, great flourishes following these events. In the present animal kingdom, 97 species are invertebrates. It means they don't have a spine, which is like all your weird little spongy, clammy things. Coral fossil, fusilinids, brachiopods, mollusca. Crustaceans, here's a complex life form. Fossil insects. Criminoids, these are like sea fans. And trilobites, these guys are real successful for a while. There's the Cambrian Sea. getting it on. It's like a nightclub in there. Krabby's, Ammonites. Insects in amber. Dino DNA. Trilobites. Who put white on gray? Who designed this? Come on, people. Jiho Fauna, first named after. First named by Grabeau in 1923. Many fossils found in the west of Liaoning. Renamed Jiho Biota by Gu Shiwei, 1960s. Among the Biota, Isiotera, Ephemeropsis, and Lycoptera are most common members. Jiho Biota exited 124 million years ago. Since 1988, many feathered dinosaurs, beautiful fossil birds, the most complete Mesozoic mammal skeletons, and the first flower in the world have been found. These brought a surge of astonishment to the whole world every time they were discovered. In the fossil record, what are they splitting shale here? They find beautiful things. Are they using it to make roof tiles? I know a lot of the stuff they discovered in England would be like some guy breaking a piece of shale or slate. You go, hey, look what I found. Let me go get that university professor. He'll give me 10 pounds for this. Well, I'm on pace to finish the museum in 2 hours. That's half a floor done. Your clothes, maybe. Dinosaur park outside, huh? Save that for when I come back down and they're ushering everyone out. Please mind the step. Who designed steps that have an overhang so you trip? That's bad designing. Function of plants. You gotta cherish them because they provide you with oxygen and food. Insects pollinate them, so they depend on us. Chrysanthemum, native to China. Cultivated history of 2,500 years, almost 10,000 breeds. The mums. Orchids. Unequal oxen. Huh. They always turn away from gravity. Positive geotropism of roots. They always follow gravity. Phototropism of plants. They'll bend to the sun. Oxen, huh? What is oxen? Plants like the secret of the mimosa. Sleeping plants. Model of a little tree. Oh, artichoke, pineapple, onion. Or garlic. It looks like garlic. Joseph Priestley. Take out the air from the vacuum. The mouse dies. Put the mouse and the plant in the vacuum and they both live. Van Helmont. Water the plant and the plant will grow. What is this? All sorts of James Bond. Carbon 3, carbon 4 pathway, and photo respiration. Chloroplast, most important machines producing organic substances. Action spectrum, photosynthesis. Wouldn't it be cool if you could get energy from the sun? Seed germinate, seedling, native sporophyte, embryo sac, pollen tube, reached ovule, pollen grain, embryo development, seed fruit. An ophiris and a bee, salvia and a wasp, and a kangaroo paw and hummingbird. Flowers specialize for certain breeding pollinators. Some even, like some types of cactus, have moths or bats that pollinate them, I've seen. Here's moths. Coevolution of plants and specialized pollinators. Yucca. Yeah, see, there's the yucca. They'll show something that's pollinated by bat, wind pollination, trap insects for pollination. They trap them. What is this, a pitcher plant? Huh. Orchids, dressed as a bride, alluring insects. It looks like the rump of a female. Get them to come in. What are these things? This is how the seeds spread. Dispersal of fruit and seeds with wings. Yeah. Acorns with hair can travel by wind. Ah, so they have little hairy things. Seeds with wings can fly like a glider. Fruit called pendant melon. This kind of plant was named pendant lamp. Some of it floats. Fruits with wings, easily traveled by wind. Seeds covered with hair can spread long distance by the wind. Chinese endemic plant. Fruits with wings, travel easily by winds. Coconut can float, drift down a river. Seed pods. Spraying out its seeds, it'll burst and throw its seeds out. There's some lotus, grasses, is this rice, caryopsis with own insert into soil of itself, burrs attached to the animals, look at that poor squirrel, they turn them into burry man, the bunny rabbit too, oak nuts, also be disseminated by animals such as squirrels who eat them, so they bury big caches of them and forget. This exhibit's for the Boyds. Survival of strategies. Pine symbiosis with fungi. Nitrogen fixing. What are we getting in here? Blue-green algae. Lichen. Fungi bacteria. Good friends among plants. Corn bean squash. Cross cold resistant plants. Ooh, this is the one from the Himalayas that surrounds itself in a big basket. Protects it from UV light too. Man eating plants. This is a carnivorous plant in nitrogen poor soil or acidic soils. Spring geophytes, deciduous forests. Euphorbia, which is a type of succulent but not a cactus. Then you have true cactuses from the southwest. Jacques-Louis David, what do we got here? Peas, toxins, bitterness to protect themselves, overcompensatory response of plants, cotton. Ooh, look at that guy eating around in a circle. A Mexican ladybug cuts off veins to curb toxin before it eats the leaf. Interesting. Cuts that out. Interesting. Heh. Defend against animals and human beings using allergic substances. Imitation, biomimicry, to look like poisonous even if you're not. Disturbing synthesis of animals' protein using rare amino acid. Seeds, paddy and soybean, native plants of China. Cultivated in so many different areas of the world now. Corn, maize from the New World. They grow a lot of corn here too. Cotton, We didn't go through here. The mums. The chrysanthemums. Remember that from Escape from Alcatraz? The mums. Modified organism, or modified organs to store nutrients. Then we eat it. We'll say, I'll take that. Purple cabbage. These become fleshy for storing nutritious substances. Storage leaves a Chinese cabbage. Cauliflower. Inflorescence becomes fleshy for storing nutritious substance. Tubers. Fruits. Pomegranate. And we're out. Gymnosperma. Broad leaves. Fertilization. Evolution of plants. The evolution of the plant. The first thing you must know about the evolution of this plant species. Plants moved down to land 400 million years ago. They started off in the ocean, just like everything. All life originates in the ocean. The original real estate is under the water. You must understand this is because people all want to live on the beach. Why do you want to live on the beach? Everyone wants to live on the beach because we originally come from under the water. Back in time. Plants moved down to land, huh? 400 million years ago during the Silurian. Cooksoni, late Silurian, oldest known fossil plant. Other early land plants appear. Early Middle Devonian, including Rhynia, Teneocrata, and Zosterophyllum. Pteridophytes, feather plants. Late Paleozoic, age of Pteridophytes. Tree ferns, giant horsetail ferns, tree-like lycopods, dominated swampy lands, Carboniferous, Devonian ages. Buried, died here, vast coal deposits, Pennsylvania and Shaanxi. Ancient pockets of sunlight is what I call them. Gymnosperms. Early Mesozoic become dominant. They're able to grow more quickly than pteridophytes. Gymnosperms develop during the Paleozoic and become dominant during the Mesozoic, which is called the Age of Gymnosperms. These plants include pteridiosperms, ginkgos, cycads, gnotophytes, and conifers. Just as gymnosperms force non-seed plants onto ecological background, the evolution of angiosperms and closed seed plants sometime during the Cretaceous forced gymnosperms into restricted habitats. Wherever the earth was cold or dry, gymnosperms could prevail, but in all their habitats, flowering plants rapidly became the dominant plant life. The Cenozoic era is the age of angiosperms. Me. I want to see the earth get green, man. Make it so green, please. Make it so, number one. Ooh, get to plant materials everywhere. Pshh. Now we are in the ancient forest. Yeah. tropical rainforest. Henan Island, Taiwan, Fujian, Guangdong, Guangxi, Yunnan, Tibet all have some tropical areas. Lungs of the earth.
It's so still, it seems almost lifeless.
Ooh.
Now these
Attenborough.
And bushes and grasses around me are living organisms, just like animals. And they have to face very much the same sort of problems.
More than 80 species of mangrove all over the world, 30 species in China. All I know is red, black, white, prop root, respiration root, buttress, leaves, viviparity. Wetlands, marsh fen peatland, natural artificial, permanent temporary, fresh brackish salt, marine water, depth low tide, not exceeding 6 meters. So if it's over 6 meters, you're in the ocean, huh? It's at low tide though, so about 20 feet. Cradle of life, kidneys of the earth. They flush out all their shit. I had a friend who was in the Peace Corps in Mali, and he took a trip to the beach, which I don't know if Mali has much of a coastline. I don't think it has anything. So he wasn't that familiar when he went on vacation to the beach in, like, Guinea. And he was walking in the area of the beach where people just go on the beach and poop and let the tide wash it out. And he was, like, totally grossed out. That's how they do it. Xeromorphic. But it's good because then a lot of plants grow in that area of the ocean, and then a lot of fish come eat the plants. And they eat the fish. Let's see. Xeromorphic perennial herb, northeast, northwest, Inner Mongolia, central northern parts of Qinghai, Tibet Plateau. Great big open plains. Deserts. High evaporative rate with low precipitation. Northwest China, northwestern part of Tibetan Plateau. Four types of vegetation. Little arbor desert, shrub desert, half shrub, little half shrub, little half shrub cushion. Chaparral. What's upstairs here?
The life of plants.
Did they do a life of plants? The BBC? Maybe. Mountains. Alpine, subalpine, montane, huh? 69% of the land areas in China is covered by hills, mountains, plateaus. Divided vertically in an evergreen broadleaf forest, evergreen broadleaf mixed forest, coniferous broadleaf mixed forest, subalpine coniferous, alpine shrub, alpine meadow, alpine scree, and snowbelt. I like the subalpine the best, where the forest opens up into a prairie, but you still have some pockets of trees before you get into the scree. We say alpine environment, but when you're really in the alpine, nothing grows taller than a few centimeters. And it's a very fragile and exposed environment. High plains can be beautiful too. The desert's got its own beauty. You just gotta learn to appreciate it. The desert grows on you. It's kind of an ironic statement if you think about it, that the desert grows. If you grow up somewhere where everything's green, you have this visceral reaction when you go to the desert, you know? And then you're shocked that the desert can get cold in the winter or at night. Animals. We got several different kind of animals. Big old croc, rhino, gemsbok, kudu, or eland. Kalahari, lions, giraffes, elephants, zebras, flamingos, hot air balloons, vultures, lion, sika, dika, duke, a duke, duke. Got all sorts of cool ungulates. The giraffe's real vulnerable when it bends down to drink. Grevy zebra looks like a cheetah, warthog. The cheetahs like to hide their kills in the trees. Jackals, hyenas like to steal, and there's a serval, another jackal down here. Ostrich, baboons stealing the ostrich's egg. Oryx. And we have the Maasai warrior, it looks like. Yeah, the Maasai. They like to use the ostrich egg to drink out of. They prick a little hole and then they fill them with water. Use them like a natural canteen. Put some netting around it and carry it. Chari Nile, Nilo-Saharan. Different tribes, huh? They get special status to travel back and forth from Kenya to Tanzania. Male has to stalk and kill a lion, I think, to become a man, which is a little crazy. They're really tall. You know why? Because they drink the blood of their cattle. They take an arrow and bink, they shoot a little hole in the frot under the neck there, the scruff of the neck, and I guess they just have to participate in a lion hunt to become a man. I wonder if you actually have to kill a lion or just go on the lion hunt. It's highly ritualized, I'm sure. That guy's ears are gauged big time. Wattle and Daub huts. Look how tall they are. So drink all that blood. You gotta drink it real quick before it congeals. They take a cup and stick it underneath the neck of the animal after they prick it to collect the blood and then gulp it down. They rarely actually will kill them for meat. Only the special celebrations and feasts, I think, they'll cull a couple of the cattle. Look how beautiful these people are, right? When I see this kind of stuff, I think, why would you ever want to live in a big city? Close-knit community with your friends, connected to the earth, happy. It's like being a middle schooler for the rest of your life. It's like the happiest time of your life, you know? You have enough freedom, but not so much that you have to worry. As long as it rains, you're fine. Or as long as no one steals your land. There's the grandma, the babysitter. That's why women go through menopause, they think, and men don't. The men have to be able to go out and show younger men how to hunt, but not be a threat to them for taking the women, so they get bald or their hair goes gray. So they have a very visible sign that they're aged and non-virile, but they still have enough wisdom. They don't go through a menopausal event, so they can go out and show you how to hunt and do all the things that the young man wants to run too much. Circumcision, funerals. Here's a dark side. Homosexuality, circumcision. They have a lot of weird stuff, you know, that wouldn't be so great for everybody. A lot of tribalism stuff too is very corrupt. You get anything, you gotta share it with everyone in the village, you know? So nobody ends up getting ahead because they say that's, I've read books that say that's one of the theories for why Africa has a lot of problems with corruption, because of the tribal mentality. And then that leads to people trying to hoard things because they don't want to share because they know everybody needs a piece of it. So then you get like the wrong attitude coming in the opposite direction. And it gets hard to work at a level beyond a community level. Because if somebody's outside your community and you don't know them, you're not going to share anything with them. They're the enemy, right? So it's hard to have anything on industry of scale or beyond the tribal level. You get intense problems with corruption. Living in the Savannah, Maasai people select. It doesn't help that we came in as colonialists and picked one tribe to subjugate the others, you know. Or a lot of times they picked us. Like, what's in his name? The guy who overthrew Mexico City there. Just happened upon one tribe that hated the other, wanted to get back at him. Or we'll help you. Precisely because the guardians like Maasai, the Afro has become a haven of life. Magnificent landscape of today. Animism, they mean. Maasai people don't hunt wild animals for food, which allows the wild animals to live comfortably in the grasslands. Discovery Corner is closed. Mystery of Animals. Jackrabbit. Snowhare. What is this? Some weird iguana. Ptarmigan. Black and white phase for winter and summer. Is this a toucan or a hornbill? Rano Party's Toco. It's a toucan. So parrot family. Look at the X legs, the X feet on the legs. Parrot family. Let's see. Where's the one with the long skinny finger? All sorts of weird creatures. Platypus. That's nothing special. Everybody knows about platypuses now. Is this a type of pheasant? Lophophorus ikesai. That's a type of pheasant. Bactrian camel. Looks like a bee on its side, right? Bactrian. One hump. Dromedary. D on its side. For storing fat. I think camels may have a process by which they can convert fat into water or something I read once. It sounded real weird. Like a neat thing to be able to do. A falcon? What is this? Baby. We have here a bear in its den. Copper pheasant. Ringneck pheasant, maybe. Bears don't go into true hibernation. We got hedgehog. Defense. Pufferfish, armadillo. Pangolin, armadillo. Kitty cat, zebra. Nautilus. Let's see, insects now we're looking at. Specialized snouts they're talking about. Anteater, or is that a sloth? Looks like an anteater. Sticky tongues. Daily routine of animals. Bats with different noses for receiving radar in their ears. The owl's face is slightly asymmetric. If you look at it close enough. Helps with echolocation. They got some good jazz playing. That's what you need at 5 o'clock is jazz. The brighter the mandrel's face on the male, the more females want to mate with them. Here's a proboscis monkey. They're pretty rare. They have rare monkeys too in Japan and China that live at high latitudes and altitudes. One eats like the hanging moss there, the fungus stuff that looks like Spanish moss. It's a real interesting monkey. Shouldn't be living in that area, but it does, survives. What do we have here? Bird doing display. Frog inflating his throat sac. There's a grouse inflating his chest sacs. I've always wanted to go to the Atwater. Frigate bird. Preserve in Texas to see that. There's a turkey puffing himself up, and an owl. Cranes dancing. What is this? Mating, I guess. They stand on top of each other. Ostrich eggs. Sometimes the eggs of cliff birds are more triangular shapes. They don't roll off the cliff. Pangolin, ferrets. Babies. You can either have a long gestation period and a very fully formed baby, or a short gestation and then an unformed baby. Marsupials are non-placental, so the baby's like a little turd that has to nurse outside. But then even you look at humans and monkeys, and they have to spend years with their parents, or they're going to be helpless. Monkeys are a good example of primates, you know, like chimps. If they don't spend years with their parents learning all the tool stuff, they're not going to survive. Fox or coyote, maybe. Looks like coyotes. Social structure is important. Usually you have a dominant breeding pair is the way most work. Most hierarchies work. Beaver, their den, birds in their tree nests, animal architects, bowerbird. Check this out, swallow nest, what is this? The bird's nest shape they built the stadium in is pretty cool. I think it was Swiss architects that did that 2008 Olympic stadium. There's the piston-like legs there, the hop-hop stupid kangaroo. Whale tail. Polar bears have hollow hairs to help insulate themselves like a styrofoam cooler. The seas, we haven't talked much about the seas. There's an aquarium in the basement though. Go check that out. What keeps things cool in the styrofoam cooler is that the styrofoam is spongy and it's got little air bubbles trapped in it. And that layer of air. It's also what keeps a lot of animals that are in the sea cool. It's the hair that the otter has trapped between its oily fur. That air helps insulate it. That's why you'll always see otters blowing into their fur. Crocodiles. I guess this is a Chinese crocodile. Alligator sinensis, Chinese alligator. Yangtze River has them. River systems, two major river systems in China. Well, they're showing the Pearl River, which comes out by Hong Kong. There's the Pearl River, there's Hainan Island, tropics are down here. Then you get into like mountainous interior. This is the Yangtze River or the Jiangnan River, and Yellow River up here comes out into Bohai. We're here. Beijing's up here, right? Tianjin, then Hubei province around it. It's all Hubei province. Yeah. Taiwan, which they say is part of China. What's down here, South China Sea? They have a big piece that goes down to like Brunei of the South China Sea that they claim for themselves, China. I think because of oil. They want the oil that's underneath it. And here's all the animals. Pandas are in Sichuan, Yunnan, monkeys, elephants down here by Thailand. Actually, Thailand doesn't border on China, does it? You have Vietnam, Laos, and Myanmar, but Thailand has no border with China. Let's see, takin, golden takin is this. Pheasants, lots of pheasants up here. What's this one? No light. Here on the middle and lower Yangtze, you have the alligator sinensis. You watch my video from the aquarium in Shanghai and Pudong there. There's the Amur tiger up by Russia. And out here in the steppes and the plateau, some ungulates. Some grouse. Golden takin, right? Taxicolor, Budocaris taxicolor. I touched one of these at the zoo the other day. They're real lax here about feeding them grass and stuff that you pick up from in front of the enclosures. Everybody's feeding them. Doesn't seem to do them any harm. Snowy owl, snow leopard, copper pheasant is that? Golden pheasant, maybe a golden pheasant up there. Beautiful bird. Mandarin ducks. Symbol of marital bliss is the mandarin duck. Here's the monkey, I think, that lives at a high altitude, the blue face. Let's see, this would be a leopard or a panther. Panthera pardus. Panther or a leopard. Yeah, a leopard. A cheetah was what I was thinking. That thing that was in the tree earlier is a cheetah. That hides its stuff. Here's the monkey, the snub-nosed monkey. One that lives at the high altitude that shouldn't. Sea turtles. Chelonia maialis. It's a green sea turtle, I think. And this is a hawksbill sea turtle, it looks like. This is a gray seal, I think. Phoca vitellina. This guy will be extinct soon. South China tiger, if he's not already. Amoyensis, South China tiger. Maybe we'll keep it alive in zoos, if we're lucky. I don't know if they're breeding them. Grubs in the trees. Pest control. Mosquitoes and disease. Moths, what is this? Invasive alien species, turtles. Frogs. Is that a rodent? Nutria, maybe? Odonta, maybe a beaver? Or a muskrat? Looks like a muskrat. Odonta is a muskrat. I surprised myself with how much you can come up with and infer and remember and probably misremember. Giraffe. Is that an Asian or an African? I think it's an Asian because of small ears. Asian elephant. Looks pretty big for an Asian. Bionics. Penguins. Contributions to the development of civilization. Domestication of animals. Is this an African wild dog or what? Piggies. Chickens. From jungle fowl, rabbit, duck, swan, goat, chickens again, and rooster, pigeons and doves, silkworms, of course, sericulture, making a silk and growing silkworms. The queen was in her garden and something fell into her teacup. It was a silkworm, and when she pulled it out of the hot tea, the silk had unraveled. Roses, are we looking at roses? Swan, mandarin duck, different types of bird, cranes, peacock, parrots, eagle, panda bear. Problem with the pandas eating bamboo, there's a lot of it, but every 100 years the bamboo flowers and entire forest will die off. Normally the panda would just move to a new area, but it can't do that when its land becomes fragmented. So, and you know, every so often the entire bamboo forest dies off after it flowers. Even though it can grow at 3 feet a day, when the flowering happens, it happens in massive numbers. Sometimes monkeys walk on their, they ambulate on two legs if they are walking through water. I've even seen them use a stick as a walking staff in water. Fishy, fishy games. Let's see, votive stuff here from prehistoric, these are like Bronze Age Chinese goo and dings. Animal contributions to the plastic arts, to the fine arts. Bronze casting. Another snow rabbit bunny, baby monkey, so cute. This DNA, what are we talking about here? Skyence, animal testing. Ooh, the first animals in space weren't people. That's for sure. 1961, cosmonaut, doggies, and monkeys. They had crazy theories about what would happen to us. People didn't think you could travel as fast as we do on trains, that we'd go insane and melt away and crazy stuff. Biomimicry is what we use in the Olympics now, modeled after shark's skin. Little tiny teeth-shaped things, praying mantis kung fu style. They're showing up there. That's what Phelps wore in the 2008 Olympics when he won all those medals. What do we got? Bats. Crabs. Specialization of your fingers is important for a lot of animals. Your arms and fingers. If you can stop walking on them, you can do really cool things with your hands. Start manipulating tools. Dodo, these are extinct animals, huh? That's a dodo anyway. I don't know, the sea dugong or sea cow, we call it a manatee. Wild horses, too many people. Anthropogenic threat to the biodiversity. What is this, giant terror bird? The moa, that went extinct. There was a moa in St. Andrews at the museum there that I went to, the biology museum. Polar bear, elk, red deer, they call this sometimes. Cervus elophus, yeah. It's an elk. We call it an elk. They call it a red deer. Butterfly. Various goats, monkeys, cats. Is that a fox up there? Bad. I don't know. Maybe it looks like that normally. Sometimes I see stuff and it doesn't look quite right. I think it's bad taxonomy. But red panda is more closely related to a skunk than it is to a panda. Loris fulgens, is it? It's a cute red panda, snub-nosed monkey. What are these things? Sheep? Looks like a sheep or a goat, I'm not sure. Snow tiger, porcupine. Is that a marten? Kitty kitties. Mandarin duck, symbol of marital bliss. They mate for life, red crown crane. They had some of those in the Hong Kong Zoo. I don't know if I saw any. There might have been some at the Hangzhou Zoo. Bear and wolf. Mangrove. Butterflies and moths. Moths are hairy, And they like nighttime, and butterflies are colorful and usually during the day, but those aren't hard and fast rules. Peacocks, giant anaconda. We're in the rainforest now. Black bear, pheasants, panda, red panda. Subtropical evergreen broadleaf forest. Malaysian sun bear, maybe. What is this guy? Neophilia nebulosa jungle cat. Tropical rainforest. Oceans, crustaceans, pufferfish, coral. Horseshoe crab, lobsters, giant crab. Gar, pufferfish, skate, hammerheads. All sorts of birds, birds of paradise, jungle fowl, spoonbill, ducks, owls, different types of raptor and crane. Mute swan back there. We're back out here by the entrance. I may have time to catch the bus over to Hong Chiao Market, grab Subway sandwich, and then make it to the Red Theater for the Kung Fu show at 5:15 if I keep it up. Ancient reptiles. This is what everybody comes for. Evolution, dinosaurs. We don't need to go into all this. Mesozoic. Everybody knows dinos. Them dinosaurs. Jawless vertebrates, origin of jaws, placoderms. I'll start a new video here.